Hello everybody and welcome to Planet Earth, the new radio station for young and interested people. My name is Max.
And I'm Luisa. Today we are dealing with some environmental issues and especially with global warming. Referring to this, we have different contributions.
And at the beginning we will start with a great song by Good Charlotte. In this song they want to show that we are all human and that we are all the same. And that they are believing in love. That love will show people what they are doing to our planet and at the same time to other people. It's called We Believe.
There's a woman crying out tonight. Her world has changed. She asked God why. Her only son has died. And now her daughter cries. She can't sleep at night. Downtown, another day for all the suits and ties. Another war to fight. There's no regard for life. How do they sleep at night? How can we make things right? Just wanna make this right.
That was Good Charlotte with their song We Believe. Let's continue with the news.
News. Greenpeace activists protest against nuclear power stations. Flooding in Austria. International demonstration for standing up against global warming. Yesterday, about 20 Greenpeace activists protested on the cupola of the nuclear reactor in Unterweser for more than 14 hours. After they climbed on the cupola, they showed a banner which said, "Nuclear power destroys Germany." Greenpeace called for the closing of 7 nuclear power stations. Although nuclear power is a low-emission way to produce energy, it is very dangerous for humans and animals in case of accidents. Therefore, Greenpeace claims that these stations are not protected well enough against acts of terrorism and plane crashes. From their point of view, it puts all humans at risk just because the politicians hide and define down the information and look for profit. On the contrary to the warnings of Greenpeace, the Christian Democrats plan to use the stations again in the future. Flooding in Austria. In the north of Germany, the sun has been shining all day. But at the same time, Bavaria and Austria are fighting with heavy rain. For 2 days it has been raining without a break. And the situation in these areas is getting serious. Within 48 hours, in Austria, 164 liters per square meter were reported. Statistically, such masses appear only every 50 years. The biggest water amount is in Lunz am See. They had 207 liters per square meter. It is possible that there are some deaths yet, because a few people are still missing. International demonstration for standing up against global warming. In the year of 2007, the greenhouse gas emissions sank. The Environmental Commissioner of the European Union, Stavros Dimas, is very confident that the intention of the Convention of Kyoto will be reached in the near future. The Convention of Kyoto was decided at international level in 1998. Its intention is the reduction of greenhouse gas emissions. The industrialized countries, for example, have to reduce the 6 most important greenhouse gases about 5.2% until 2012. Germany is on a good way to reduce the gases. In contrast to Germany, in the USA, you can see that the greenhouse gas emissions are rising up rather than being reduced. The USA is far away from reaching the intentions of the Kyoto Protocol. Also, the USA decided to make a new step straight on against global warming, thanks to Barack Obama. Some countries are reducing their greenhouse gas emissions yet, but it is not enough, and in regard to this, thousands of people are traveling to Paris, Berlin, London and Rome. They want to demonstrate for the reduction of greenhouse gas emissions all over the world, and they want to wake up everyone who still has their eyes closed. The demonstration in Berlin starts at the Brandenburg Gate at 10 o'clock a.m. tomorrow, the 1st of July. Report. The following sequence will be presented by our reporters Nessie, Alina and Vanessa. They are going to inform you about the 36-year-old woman Julia Butterfly Hill, who is an activist against deforestation. Here is Nessie, Alina and Vanessa.
Cutting down a tree. Do you know which consequences it has? Probably not. Trees produce oxygen and humans produce carbon dioxide. They need the gases from each other to live. This means they are dependent on each other, because the trees need the carbon dioxide and the humans need the oxygen. The natural balance would be destroyed if one of them was extinct. But why are humans so destroying and cut trees down if they need them so much? Streets, furniture and malls are probably more important to them. Some people don't care about it, but others risk their lives to save our environment. Julia Butterfly Hill is one of those persons. Instead of making career, she climbed on a 65-meter-high tree and lived there for 2 years, all this time without leaving the tree for a minute. There she lived on a small platform out of wood. She gave up all the normal living standards, like a toilet, her own restaurant and her career as a photo model.
The only way of cooking was with a gas cooker. Julia was supported by friends, family and other activists who brought her vegetarian food and other things she needed. To stay in contact with the outside world, she had a mobile phone and built a smaller platform under the bigger one. She did all this only for one redwood tree. The tree was named Luna because Julia and the so-called Earth First organization built a platform in the full moonlight. 12 years ago, Julia Butterfly Hill climbed up the tree in the deepest and very stormy winter. The only protection for her was a canvas of a tent. Not only the weather, but also the Pacific Lumber organization made it difficult for her in such an unnormal situation.
The Pacific Lumber had to cut the tree down for a timber industry. They flew helicopters above her and hoped that she would fall down. They have done nearly everything to make her give up without caring about her life. Because of her action, she became famous, and she uses this fame to collect money for her own and other environmental organizations. Julia Butterfly Hill is an example for an extreme activist. In our nearest area in Frankfurt, there was a smaller tree protection too. The reason was the upgrading of the Frankfurt airport. In contrast to Julia's case, where the tree Luna still stands today, the try of the activists in Frankfurt failed.
Back to the studio.